Talk about impact. Raven, Kurt Hennig, and the returning Sting. I'm Scott Hudson. He's the living legend, Larry Zbyszko, and this is WCW Pro on TBS. Legend, who is the impact player?
Boy, what a question. You know something, Scott? That's the same question that Hollywood Hulk Hogan is asking Dennis Rodman, mm-hmm. and that Scott Hall is asking Kevin Nash, mm-hmm. and that Vicious is asking Delicious. Mm-hmm. In other words, the New World Order is now in the dark, and they don't know either what Henning's doing, what Raven's doing, who Diamond Dallas Page's partner is, right. who the Impact player is. Keep them guessing, boys, and keep them off balance.
What a nitro it was at the MGM Grand in Las Vegas. We saw the debut of Kurt Hennig, Raven, and the return of Sting. We still don't know who the Impact player was. We've got it narrowed down to three. Who is Dallas Page's partner? That and much more, but right now it's to the ring on WCW Pro.
You know, Scott, with all these questions we were just talking about, there still are a couple big questions WCW has to ask itself. Where does Hennig stand? Where does Raven stand? Are they with WCW? Could they be with the New World Order?
That is a question for the ages, but I don't know that WCW could stand it. I don't know that we can survive, Larry, if both Kurt Hennig and Raven join up with the New World Order. That may be the nail in our coffin.
Definitely a bad time with two of the greatest human chess players of all times at each other's throats. And I'm talking, of course, of Piper and Flair. What bad timing for WCW to have these two guys focused against each other instead of guys like, you know, Hollywood Hogan and Dennis Rodman and Hall and Nash. It's bad timing for WCW.
You know, things would be going really swell for the New World Order.
Swell?
Swell.
How many times have you watched Leave It to Beaver?
Counting today?
Never
things
mind.
Things would be swell in the New World Order if Hogan and Rodman didn't have to face Luger and the Giant at Bash at the Beach, and that may just ruin their Sunday.
Well, I tell you, I mean, Hogan's not a dumb man.
No.
He knows Rodman's limitations. Rodman's great to punch somebody when they're down, to kick somebody from behind, to beat up a photographer. But Hogan knows that Rodman can't stand toe-to-toe against the Giant or Luger. So Hogan has got something up his sleeve. Mark my words. And, you know, Luger and the Giant, be warned.
It's a good point from the living legend, Larry Zbyszko. Lex Luger and the Giant, I'm sure, will have eyes in the back of their heads come Bash at the Beach on the 13th on pay-per-view. Because Hulk Hogan, as we've said before, he knows.
Whoa!
Whoa, what a dropkick from Billy Kidman. He knows that Rodman is in over his head, and he's going to have some trick. He's going to have something planned if he hopes to win the match at Bash at the Beach. Whoa, nice savate kick.
That Kidman better have a better plan, too. He's rushing in.
Former television champion Prince Iaukea with a cradle hooks the leg. Doesn't get the pinfall on Billy Kidman. Billy Kidman and Prince Iaukea starting it off here on WCW Pro.
Whoa, nice snap there, but his pressure's way too low on Kidman. Got to keep it on the shoulders.
Was a nice bridge from Prince Iaukea, but did not get the pinfall. Elbow to the back of the head of Billy Kidman. Still to come on this program, we will see Mortis with James Vandenberg in his corner. We'll see the tag team of the Faces of Fear. Glacier also in action in the main event today. The Public Enemy face Rage and Chaos of High Voltage. That's all still to come here on WCW Pro.
Now looks like Kidman just made some mistakes there, and he's not recouping for a small guy not getting up fast. That's a bad sign. Iaukea being more aggressive, and that's
sunset flip from Kidman. Hooks him, but Prince Iaukea kicks out. Count of two. Kidman still. Small package from Kidman. Count of two. Oh, Kidman still with his head in the game. No question about it. Prince Iaukea sends his man into the corner, shoulders into the midsection. Gonna send Kidman across. Reversal by Kidman. The Prince hits the turnbuckle. Backflip by Prince Iaukea, and Kidman on the apron blocks it. Couple of right forearms to the top of the head of Prince Iaukea and a shoulder to the midsection.
Well, hit him low and, oh, hooked him by the head. Gotta get up quick though.
Rolling head scissors into a body slam by Billy Kidman, and Kidman back in control over the former television champion, Prince Iaukea. What a victory it would be for Billy Kidman here on the Pro.
Well, all these guys here, they want their careers to go on, but we got two guys coming up. Benoit Sullivan may not have a career left.
It could all end at Bash at the Beach for Chris Benoit or Kevin Sullivan. It will end for one or the other. We'll talk more about that as we go through the pro show today here on TBS. Brett Iaukea sets his man up. Looks like a power bomb. No, he's going to set him up. Hooks him, sets him across the back. Kidman, Kidman reverses.
Iaukea holds on. He rolled through it. He got him.
Momentum reversal by Brett Iaukea as Kidman turned it into a victory roll. Iaukea just went with it and hooked his man into a sunset flip, pinning predicament to open it up with the victory on the pro here for Prince Iaukea. Good victory for the Prince. He's back to the winning ways. Stay with us right now.